سمو الشيخ منصور بن محمد بن راشد المكتوم رئيس نادي دبي للرياضات البحرية، أصحاب السعادة، ضيوفنا الأكارم، فنانين المميزين من جميع أنحاء العالم، نرحب بكم في الدورة السابعة من جائزة حمدان بن محمد بن راشد المكتوم الدولية للتصوير الضوئي هيبا. Your Highness Sheikh Mansour bin Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, Chairman of Dubai International Marine Club. Your Excellencies, distinguished guests, and the many talented photographers who joined us from around the globe. We welcome you to the seventh season of Hamdan bin Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum International Photography Awards. لقد قامت هيبا من جديد بجمع مصورين بجمع مصورين ماهرين من جميع أنحاء العالم تحت سقف واحد، وعلى الرغم من تنوع خلفياتهم إلا أنهم توحدوا بإبداعهم لفتح آفاق جديدة لأفكارنا وعواطفنا. وعبر منظورهم الفني فإن الصور التي ستعرض اليوم هي بمثابة دعوة لنا جميعا لنعيش اللحظة. HIPA this year has again brought together some of the world's most skilled photographers from a myriad of diverse backgrounds. Through their eyes, the images on show will open up new perspectives, will stir your thoughts and emotions, and will serve as an invitation for us all to live the moment. ضيوفنا الأفاضل، رحبوا معي الآن بسعادة الأمين العام لجائزة حمدان بن محمد بن راشد آل مكتوم الدولية للتصوير الضوئي علي خليفة بن ثالث. Please join us now and welcome him to the stage, the Secretary General of the Hamdan bin Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum International Photography Award, His Excellency علي خليفة بن ثالث.
سمو الشيخ منصور بن محمد بن راشد آل مكتوم رئيس نادي دبي الدولي للرياضات البحرية، أصحاب السمو والمعالي والسادة الحضور، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نحتفل معكم اليوم بطي مسيرة الدورة السابعة من الجائزة، والتي كانت بعنوان اللحظة، والتي لفتنا فيها أنظار العالم لقيمة اللحظة الراهنة، وفتحنا المجال واسعاً لتفسيرات الترجمة الفوتوغرافية للزمن. وفق رؤية سمو الشيخ حمدان بن محمد بن راشد آل مكتوم ولي عهد دبي راعي الجائزة، نواصل مسيرتنا في التثقيف البصري والإضاءة على كافة المواضيع والاتجاهات التي تستفز طاقات المصورين الإبداعية وتحافظ على توقد الحافز لديهم لصناعة المستحيل. نحتفل معكم اليوم بحفل يسمح بحضور اللحظة فقط، ويضع الماضي والمستقبل على قائمة الانتظار. إنها احتفالية زمنية خاصة تنقل لكم قراءات شعوب العالم للحظة التي تداهمنا، وتترك فينا أثراً لا يمحوه الزمن، وتتشارك معكم روائع الأعمال المصنوعة بتقنية التايملابس، وهو الفاصل الزمني لأول مرة. نحتفل معكم اليوم بتمدد رقعة الجائزة وصولاً إلى 196 دولة حول العالم، متخطين حاجز 300 ألف مشارك من مجموع الدورات السابقة. واستجابة لتوجيهات سمو راعي الجائزة في دعم العمل الإنساني، أطلقنا في نوفمبر الماضي مشروع لكم الإنساني السنوي، الذي أهدى رسائل المحبة والتواصل المعطاءة لآلاف الأطفال حول العالم. ولأن الأخبار الجميلة منتظرا في هكذا مناسبات، أحمل لكم مفاجأة سارة للموسم القادم. سمو الشيخ حمدان بن محمد بن راشد المكتوم ولي عهد دبي رئيس المجلس التنفيذي راعي الجائزة، سيقوم شخصيا باختيار ثلاثة صور فائزة تحت الجوائز الخاصة وفق آلية سيعلن عنها لاحقا بإذن الله. وفي هذا المقام أعرب بالأصالة عن نفسي ونيابة عن زملائي في الأمانة العامة عن خالص العرفان لدعم سمو الشيخ حمدان بن محمد بن راشد المكتوم الغير محدود للجائزة، ورفض مسيرتها برأس مور وتوجيهاتها السديدة. كما أشكر فريق العمل على أدائهم الإبداعي المتفوق الذي تشعرون بقيمته الراقية طوال العام. نبارك لكل الفائزين الذين حصدوا نتائج جهدهم، ونهيب بهم أن يكونوا سفراء لتجارب فوزهم وتفاصيله. وملهمين لمن حولهم بالطاقة الإيجابية التي لا تنضب. ونشكرهم على تذكير زملائهم المشاركين في الدورات القادمة بضرورة الانتباه للبنود القانونية لمسابقات التصوير تفادياً لضياع مجهود كبير لأسباب صغيرة. نشكركم على حضوركم ونذكركم باستلام هديتكم البصرية المميزة كتاب اللحظة الذي يحوي روائع مشاركاتكم في هذه الدورة، والذي سيساعدكم في منح اللحظة مساحة هامة في ذاكرة المستقبل. نترككم الآن مع فيديو قصير لزيارتنا لمخيم اللاجئين السوريين في الأردن بعد 4 سنوات من زيارتنا الأولى. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بعد 4 سنوات من المبادرة الأولى التي قامت بها الجائزة في هذا المخيم الطيب، مخيم رجيم الحوت تابع للهلال الأحمر في المملكة الأردنية الهاشمية، وجدت الجائزة في ضرورة استكمال هذه المبادرة إلى نقطة أبعد. ارتأينا في مجلس أمناء الجائزة بتفعيل فكرة الصورة اللي هي صورت في هذا المخيم قبل 4 سنوات. إن شاء الله راح نزور المخيم اليوم بفكرة أن نحن راح نجيب للأولاد صورهم اللي نحن صورناها قبل 4 سنوات، وراح نهديهم إياها كمبادرة أو هدية من الجائزة ومن دبي ومن دولة الإمارات العربية المتحدة. وإن شاء الله راح نشوف وقع استلامهم الصور عليهم، وإن شاء الله يعجبهم. أي مصور أو أي فنان بأنه لديه الكثير من العمل لكي يقدمه، ليس العمل خلف الكاميرا فقط. أنت من خلال هذه البرامج تيقن وتكون على يقين بأنك تستطيع أن تقدم أشياء كثيرة من خلال فنك.
موقع استلام الصور للأطفال أعاد تعريف التصوير الفوتوغرافي في أذهاننا للأبد.
نعم، مبادرة بالفعل تستحق التقدير لنشرها الفرح بين أولئك الذين بالفعل يستحقون هذا الفرح. A really beautiful initiative spreading joy among some very deserving people. لقد تم اختيار محاور هذه الليلة بعناية فائقة، بحيث تفتح مجال الاستكشاف الفني للمصورين وتحفيز فكرهم الإبداعي والتقني على حد سواء. The categories that we present tonight have been carefully chosen and selected to allow our photographers to fully explore their ideas both creatively and technically. فبالإضافة إلى تكريم الأشكال التقليدية من التصوير الضوئي، تستمر هيبا في تحدي كل ما هو مألوف عن طريق دفع حدود التعبير الفوتوغرافي، الأمر الذي سيتجلى أمامنا اليوم ضمن الموسم السابع. In addition to honoring the traditional forms of photography, HIPAA also continues its tradition of challenging conventions as our 7th season pushes the boundaries of photographic expression. فباحتضانها لكافة الإبداعات والابتكارات العصرية في مجال التصوير، تقدم هيبا هذا الموسم محور الفاصل الزمني The Time Lapse، وهي تقنية التصوير التي يتم من خلالها التقاط سلسلة من الصور الرقمية بالتدريج ويتم عرضها في تتابع معين لتشكل معزوفة بصرية متحركة. Embracing the trends and innovation of modern photographic practice, this year sees the introduction of the time-lapse category, a technique in which a series of digital images are captured progressively and displayed in sequence to form a moving composition. محورنا الرئيسي لهذا العام يعكس موضوع موسم هيبا السابع ألا وهو اللحظة حيث بذل المتنافسون قصارى جهدهم لالتقاط الكمال في جزء من الثانية لتجسيد هذه الفكرة. This year's theme of HIPAA's seventh season, The Moment, requires nothing short of perfect split-second timing and vision from our competitors as they strive to capture an image that embodies this idea. يسعدني الآن أن أرحب بأول مقدم لهذا المساء وهو عضو في لجنة تحكيم هذا الموسم. I would now like to introduce the first presenter of the evening and member of the season's judging panel. هو فنان بمعنى الكلمة وخلفيته في الفنون الجميلة والرسم كان لها دور كبير في ارتقاء مهاراته في مجال التصوير الضوئي. شغفه بحركة الضوء واستخلاص اللحظة قاده لاستكشاف وتطوير تقنيات وأساليب مبتكرة ضمن تخصصه في مجال الفاصل الزمني أو التايم لابس. حازت أعماله على العديد من الجوائز العالمية وبصفته عالماً ومعلماً فإنه ما زال يواصل البحث والاستكشاف في هذا المجال المعاصر. A true artist in every sense of the word. His background in fine arts and painting triggered his fascination with the movement of light and the compression of time. Exploring technologies to master time-lapse photography, his work has received numerous global awards and recognitions. As scholar and teacher, he continues to explore this exciting field of digital media. حضورنا الكريم رحبوا معي بالسيد بيتر بيل. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Mr. Peter Bell. ضيفنا التالي هو أحد الفائزين بالجائزة الخاصة. نشأ محاطا بالأخبار وترعرع في منطقة موبوءة بالنزاع. بدأ حبه للتصوير الفوتوغرافي في سن مبكرة وقام باستخدام مهاراته وحرفته لنشر الوعي وإلقاء الضوء على قصص أولئك الذين يعيشون في أصعب الظروف. Born and raised in a region plagued by conflict, our second presenter and special award recipient grew up surrounded by the news with a love of photography which was cultivated from an early stage. He has used his craft to spread awareness, shedding light on the stories of those that live in the most difficult of circumstances. نرحب الآن أعزائي الحضور بالسيد محمد محيسن. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Mr. محمد محيسن.
Good evening, Mohammed.
Good evening.
Let's begin our awards tonight with the general category, made up of the three essentials associated with photography, light, shade, and hue.
Absolutely, Peter. Embodying the first two of these characteristics is a black and white category. Many of our fellow photographers consider it to be one of the true tests of photographic skill. In many ways, the black and white photographer can be seen as someone who purposely defies the complexity of the art.
That's true. Confident in their ability to create, only a true master is able to work within a limited palette of essential ingredients, mixing them in just the right proportion to produce an image for the ages.
سيداتي وسادتي، أدعو الآن معالي الشيخة لبنى بن خالد القاسمي وزيرة الدولة لشؤون التسامح لتقديم الجوائز للفائزين بالمحور الأول. We now welcome to the stage Her Excellency شيخة لبنى بن خالد القاسمي, Minister of State for Tolerance, to present the awards to the winners of our first category.
Begin the awards in the black and white category. In third place is Yusuf Thiab from Kuwait.
The fierce white-tailed sea eagle, seen through spread wings, a striking image of the ultimate airborne predator. Preparing to strike, its intense gaze fixed upon its target.
And second place is awarded to Quanhui Liu from China.
The craft of two artists merge in this photograph. The perfect timing of the photographer and that of an 80-year-old carpenter skillfully weaving his bamboo baskets.
And receiving the first place award in the very competitive category of black and white is from Iran, Mahdi Purebadi.
That shows the enduring quality of nature. Piercing through the snow-capped peaks of Iran, a lonely tree stands tall in frozen isolation.
When thinking of color, we are most likely to imagine a rainbow. Color is often associated with our own diversity, with the differences that can be blended together to be harmonious and complementary.
But as we know, Peter, not all colors will work in a successful composition. For those photographers who have made it to the finals in this category, tonight. What is not shown is just often important as what is.
The winner of the third place in the color category is unfortunately unable to be here tonight. But please give a round of applause to American Michael Christopher Brown.
Perfectly framed by two soaring peaks, a young boy tends to his flock of goats in the fertile plains of a volcano in the Democratic Republic of the Congo.
And the second place award goes to Jason Cliff from Canada.
Entitled Tired Memory, we see into the eyes and mind of an elderly woman suffering from Alzheimer's disease, her gaze searching for meaning in a world that she no longer recognizes.
Taking the first prize award for the color section of our general category is Zhu Yiding from China.
A long train journey through the countryside, their destination, for now, out of reach. The passengers in this carriage, one by one, slump into a state of sleep. All except a monk, seen sitting cross-legged, eyes shut in meditation, a moment of poise and serenity.
Often, we may see a single stunning image that will take our breath away, a perfect moment.
In many instances, though, it is the story leading up to that moment that's really interesting.
I agree. I think this may be able to provide us with valuable context and a deeper appreciation for what we have seen.
Much more than just a theme, a collection of images is an opportunity to tell a story.
It does enable the viewer to widen their perspective and to focus on other details that may have otherwise been hidden from the view.
So yes, it is these moments, once combined into a portfolio, which give us a narrative of ideas, as well as a deeper glimpse into the mind and method of the photographer.
Thank you.
تسرني الآن دعوة معالي محمد أحمد المر رئيس مجلس إدارة مؤسسة مكتبة محمد بن راشد آل مكتوم رئيس مجلس أمناء جائزة محمد بن راشد للغة العربية لتقديم الجوائز الفائزين بمحور ملف المصور. We welcome now to the stage His Excellency محمد أحمد المر Chairman of the Board of Directors of the Muhammad bin Rashid Al Maktoum Library Foundation, Chairman of the Board of Trustees of the Muhammad bin Rashid Award for Arabic Language, to present the award to the winners of the portfolio category.
Our first Emirati finalist in this year's awards, fifth place goes to Muhammad Al-Mis'abi from the United Arab Emirates.
Emerging from the stark desert dunes on the island of Socotra, residents from the village of Najd perform a daily ritual, walking their camels as their ancestors have for generations. Their path carves across the pure white sand.
With another set of black and white images, the fourth place goes to Sergio Sperna from Italia.
A cold winter's morning. A blanket of fog lays across the North Italian countryside. The sun's rays slowly but surely penetrate the mist. Its beams of warmth project upon the trees standing tall to greet them.
And the winner of the third place is from Bulgaria, Boryana Katsazdrova.
The harsh Balkan winter is but one more challenge that must be overcome by Afghan and Pakistani refugees. Having made the long and perilous journey to Europe, they keep shelter from the cold in makeshift camps, hoping for a better life.
The second place winner of the portfolio category wasn't able to join us tonight. Please put your hands together for Probal Rashid from Bangladesh.
Facing an arduous march to find safety, the Rohingya trudge through the mud at the height of the monsoon season. They must not only carry the weak in their arms and all they have on their backs, but they carry the hopes of their people as well.
And taking home the first place award in the portfolio category is Paul Nicklin from Canada.
Change. The species that thrive in the Arctic and Antarctic regions are a testament to survival. In a seemingly barren and hostile environment, the animals found in these fragile ecosystems have evolved to live in harmony with their habitat.
Time, it is a force that is subjective and open to human interpretation.
And while it cannot really be seen, it is a fact of life. We have created tools that measure it, capture it, and quantify it. But indeed, the perception of time is personal. It is relative.
That's right, Mohammed. And a lapse in time illustrates this idea perfectly. Much like the medium of film, a series of moments flashing before our eyes creates an illusion, and in the case of the photographic time lapse, restores life to the subject matter, projecting it forward, providing it with vivid momentum.
As we will now witness, the finalists of this exciting new category have, through their work, become the masters of time.
Thank you.
الجوائز في محور التايم لابس أو الفاصل الزمني يشرفني أن أدعو معالي عبد الرحمن بن محمد العويس وزير الصحة ووقاية المجتمع ووزير الدولة لشؤون المجلس الوطني الاتحادي ورئيس مجلس أمناء الجائزة. To present the awards in our time lapse category, we're honored to welcome to the stage His Excellency عبد الرحمن بن محمد العويس, Minister of Health and Prevention, Minister of State for Federal National Council, and Chairman of the HEPA Board of Trustees.
Starting off with the fifth place winner, we have Ignacio Teherina Gurusiaga from España.
In a remote part of the Pyrenees, on the border between France and Spain and the slopes of the Navarra, the darkness of the long night finally meets the dawn light.
Place goes to Awad Al-Atawi from Saudi Arabia.
The darkness can seem almost absolute in the deserts of Saudi Arabia, were it not for the pollution of the city's pulsing lights. But it is here, when our gaze is focused upon the night sky, that the beauty and wonder of the cosmos can be seen in all of its glory.
Unfortunately, the third place winner, Amin Al-Ghaberi, was not able to be with us tonight. However, please join me in congratulating his brother, Zirab Al-Ghaberi, who is here to accept the award in his brother's stead.
Is one of the most distinctive and beautiful features of Yemeni architecture. Here, it frames and reveals the movement of the moon on the rooftops of the ancient buildings in Old Sana'a.
And this time, the winner of the second place is from Spain, Oscar Carrasco Rajel.
More than 15,000 individual images captured over a 22-day period, Silkworm explores nature's process of evolution in a dystopian and abandoned environment.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give a round of applause for the first place winner of the time-lapse category from Slovenia.
Veno Saradze.
Rising like a beacon in the sky, the glistening mirror-like tiles of the world's tallest skyscraper shines over an ever-changing landscape, a dazzling vision of hope for visitors from around the globe.
Behind the lens is that a moment by its nature is fleeting. A moment is elusive. It's often unrecognized except by those that have the eyes to see. Those that have trained their senses to recognize the eternity in a moment.
We both have witnessed that there are really no ordinary moments. Each and every second is an opportunity, an invitation that is either seized or lost. A moment can be a profound experience, a point of time that can define all that has come before, or set a path to follow, an invitation for both the photographer and the viewer to live the moment.
سيداتي وسادتي، قبل الانتقال إلى اللحظة المنتظرة سأتوقف قليلا لتكريم إنجازات تميزت وتعدت نطاق المنافسة في مجال التصوير الضوئي. Ladies and gentlemen, as we move closer to the pinnacle of our awards, we now pause to honor achievements in photography that quite simply are beyond the scope of competition. فكل عام تقوم هيبا بتكريم المساهمات المتفانية في تطوير ودعم فن التصوير، سواء كانت من قبل أفراد أو منظمات، وبالتالي تم تخصيص محور الجوائز الخاصة كمبادرة لتقدير أولئك الذين يساعدون في تغيير مفهوم حرفة التصوير والدور الذي تلعبه ضمن حضارتنا المعاصرة. Every year, HIPAA seeks out individuals, organizations, and innovators who have, through the years of sustained contributions, evolved and advanced the craft of photography. The HIPAA Special Awards have been created to honor those who have changed our very perception of photography and the role it plays in our modern civilization. ولمساعدتنا على تكريم هذه الجهود المميزة، فإنه من دواعي سروري أن أرحب على المسرح بعضو مجلس أمناء HIPAA السيد هنري دلال، الذي أوصله شغف حياته وتفانيه لتحقيق التميز. To help us in honoring the accomplished recipients of these awards, it is with great pleasure that we welcome to the stage HIPAA Board of Trustees member Mr. Henry Dallal, a photographer whose lifelong passion and dedication to the pursuit of excellence has seen his work recognized around the world.
The first special award this evening is the Photography Appreciation Award, a category that recognizes a person or group who has shown long-standing commitment to enhancing the art of photography. This year's winner is a photojournalist whose work you would have encountered during a career that has taken him around the world. He has devoted his camera to documenting wars, conflicts, and critical social issues. His pictorial coverage of human tragedies, such as the Rwandan genocide and the Somali famine, has helped him evolve photojournalism from merely a profession to a mission. It has also earned him numerous honors, including the coveted Ron Kappa Gold Medal, which he has won 5 times, as well as title of Magazine Photographer of the Year, which he has received 7 times.
Thank you.
the label of photography content creator, the second of our special awards aims to acknowledge the fact that the art of photography is no longer limited to taking stunning images, but also extends to all digital content which has a positive impact on the industry. Our winner this evening has pictorially covered some of modern history's worst natural disasters, such as the devastating tsunami of 2004 and Hurricane Katrina in 2005. His work has graced the pages of not just magazines like National Geographic, Smithsonian, and Outside, but also mainstream titles like Vanity Fair, Life, and the New York Times. As a tireless advocate for the environment, his work has won him numerous titles and awards from societies and associations dedicated to nature. His more recent work on climate change shows not just his mastery of time-lapse photography techniques, but also his grasp on the gravity of the threat facing our planet.
Through the 90s, I watched the global warming story evolve. And frankly, for a while, I was a skeptic too. Eventually, I became convinced that global warming is very real and it's the biggest environmental story of our time. In this project, I have a unique opportunity to use these amazing tools of photography to show people the reality of what's happening right here, right now. The day will come when these landscapes have disappeared. And the only way the memory will be preserved is through these pictures.
I think we're living in an incredibly decisive moment of historic geologic time. And I think it's an amazing opportunity to see epic things happening right in front of our eyes.
We've stationed 26 cameras at 15 different glaciers, Iceland, the Alps, the Rockies, British Columbia, and Alaska. These cameras shoot one frame every hour on the hour as long as it's daylight for over 2 years. In the end, we'll have an extraordinary record of the world in flux.
Special award is presented to an emerging person or organization that has shown outstanding work or vision in the photography industry on a national, regional, or international level. True to form, this year's winner has covered major events in the region, including the Israeli-Palestinian conflict and the US-led war in Iraq. His lens, which has earned him multiple accolades, including two Pulitzer Prizes, has documented some of the Middle East's most pivotal moments of upheaval, including the funeral of late Palestinian leader Yasser Arafat, the capture of former Iraqi President Saddam Hussein, the Yemeni Revolution, and the Syrian Civil War. Thank you.
الشيخ منصور بن محمد بن راشد المكتوم رئيس نادي دبي الدولي للرياضات البحرية لتقديم الجوائز للفائزين. I now invite His Excellency Sheikh Mansour bin Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, Chairman of Dubai International Marine Club, to the stage to present the award to the winner. رحبوا معنا بالفائز الأول بالجائزة التقديرية لهذا الموسم, James Nachtwey. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the Photography Appreciation Award is James Nachtwey. الفائز بجائزة صناع المحتوى الفوتوغرافي, James Baylog. The winner of the Photography Content Creator Award is James Baylog. بجائزة الشخصية أو المؤسسة الفوتوغرافية الواعدة, السيد محمد محيسن. The winner of the special award for an emerging person or organization is محمد محيسن. نختتم بهذا فقرة الجوائز الخاصة لهذه الليلة. أما الآن ننتقل إلى المحور الأخير وعنوان هذا الموسم من الجائزة, ألا وهو اللحظة. This concludes our special awards for tonight. We now move to the final category and theme of this year's HIPAA Award, the moment.
Trained themselves to live in each moment, to concentrate on the present with a razor-sharp focus, immersing themselves in each frame of time in order to reveal its beauty and its wonder.
In fifth place, from China, Rubo Wu.
During a natural disaster, more often than not, the deciding factor between life and death is the tenacity of the human spirit. It is at these times that communities work together for the benefit of a few, and the power of collective effort prevails.
The winner of the fourth place is not able to be with us to collect his award. Marcos Fur from Argentina.
The Gaucho's dog is an important partner on the ranch in Argentina. Here, we see one animal corralling another, nipping at its heels as it leads the larger of the two slowly towards the inevitable, the red-hot cattle brand of its owner.
At third place, award winner this season is Maxim Kotryshenko from Russia.
An image of chaos. A truck's unforeseen momentum startles a group of journalists. Fleeing for their lives, a photographer captures the horrific moment.
And receiving a second place prize, as well as his second award this evening, is Canadian Paul Nicklin.
In the Ross Sea in Antarctica, a stunning moment is captured as an adult emperor penguin seemingly defies gravity to magically take flight. Leaping from the ocean after a long journey, it returns to the ice edge for the first time in many days to bring food and nourishment to its waiting family.
And now, the first place award in the moment category goes to
Kayan Massad from Bangladesh.
Consecutive days of walking without food or water in the harshest conditions, a group of Rohingya women and their children finally make it into the Cox's Bazar district of Bangladesh, their perilous journey coming to an end.
It is time to present the coveted HIPAA Grand Prize.
Last year was supposed to be a beautiful day for civilian residents of Ar-Rashidin neighborhood in western Aleppo. With their safe passage finally negotiated, they were going to be escorted to safety.
This auspicious spring day, however, quickly turned fatal when an explosion rocked the area. A car bomb targeting civilians tore apart what was left of their lives. Like other photojournalists present to cover the events, the winner of our grand prize tonight turned his camera towards the carnage and documented the tragic moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, the moment we have all been waiting for, the HIPAA seventh season grand prize goes to
Mohammed Al-Haragab from Syria.
Panic and fear quickly turn to heroic action. Photojournalists go from covering the news to becoming part of it. In this chilling image, we see the moment a photographer can no longer just look through a lens at the horror of the world. The man, camera still in hand, cradling an injured child, runs towards help. The horror on his face symbolizing the pain and anguish of an entire nation.
Sadly, the war in Syria has prevented Mohammed from attending tonight's ceremony. At just 21 years of age, he's not only the youngest recipient of our grand prize, but also the youngest winner in our grand prize award in history.
With us, however, is another young Syrian who is at the very heart of this touching human story, captured by our winning entry. Overwhelmed by the tragic events unfolding around him, the camera-wielding photojournalist is seen rushing to the aid of an injured child at a moment when humanity decisively triumphed over professional duty.
We we would now like to invite to the stage photojournalist Abdulqadir Haba to receive the Hitra Merit Medal for his incredible act of courage.
لجميع الفائزين والجميع مدعو لحضور افتتاح معرض الجائزة لصور الفائزين ولا تنسوا نسختكم من كتاب اللحظة من مكتب التسجيل. So congratulations for all the winners and please join us after the ceremony in the unveiling of the winners gallery and the foyer and please remember to collect your copy of the Moments book.